hint, when you're playing with stuff like this, maybe don't touch this stuff, don't have a few of these because your vision starts becoming kind of blurry. Oh, well, hey guys. All right, just wanted to show you something. There's another piece coming, but I just picked up this. Didn't cost me a cent. At our cash converters, secondhand place or whatever. I seen this, and without spending anything, I said to the guy, how would you go on a trade? What are you trading? So now a couple of CD players, which are DJ CD players that I haven't touched in a long time. I took them out of a venue a while ago, and some of the buttons were a bit on the dodgy side. But anyway, he accepted a trade. So I grabbed this. Now the reason I grabbed this is that system I've got outside. I actually wanted to upgrade the amp. So, got this. You would have seen the CD player if you saw that video. Now I'm gonna upgrade it with this. And I got the other another piece, but I'll show you soon. But let's have a look at this first. This is the Pioneer VSX D512. It is not a new amplifier at all. It's been around for a few years. There's no HDMI input, which is fine by me because I only want it for music. So all I need is RCA inputs, which has got plenty of those. And it even comes with a remote. So yeah, I'll bring you a bit of a closer look before I start gutting out there, pulling everything out and pulling wires out to wire this thing up. I'll bring it in, we'll have a bit of a look at the front. I'll spin it around and have a look at the back. All right, well here we are. This is the front. So you got all your buttons on the front here. It's volume there. It's 120 watt amp. I need nowhere near that amount of power at all. But you got, which is unusual, a tone button on the front. Now, I haven't seen a tone button on the front of an amp for quite a few years. And a loudness button. Normally everything's done within the system and you do it like on screen display. But either way, this is just for outside, so I don't need nothing big, flash. Even though, once again, this is probably a little flashy to be outside, but who gives a crap? But that's the front, let's spin her around. Okay, well, this is the back. Now, normally your HDMI inputs would be up the top here. There's no HDMI inputs, which is fine, because that is not what I'm going to use it for. But you got your front speakers, your center, your surrounds. Now, your center and surrounds, I'm not going to use that at all. Would have been good if it actually had front speakers A and B. Doesn't. No big deal, doesn't matter. Because the way I said, I've virtually got this for nothing because those decks, I'll never use them. But I'm going to go and gut everything, then put her up. All right, now, this is what we've got here. If you saw my other video, you would have seen me putting this thing together. Now, what I'm going to take out, I won't be needing this EQ anymore. We'll see why soon. This amplifier, the Samsung amp, normally I wouldn't need it. I may still need to use it because obviously the other amp has got a subwoofer out, but they tend to want to go into a powered sub. Well, that one that's up there, is not a powered sub. So this may need to stay just so the sub can get powered. So this would be acting as its amplification for the sub up there. We'll see, but I think that will need to stay. Let's rip half this stuff out. Okay, well, first up, the EQ. The EQ's got to come out, which means I've got to run this cable, or the power lead, I've got to run it out. The speakers, because I still want to use the switcher box here to go down to the carport compared to out here. So I guess, the speaker line out of the Samsung will be the one, that's at the input of this. ¶¶
I know how I'm going to do this, but let's hope I don't drop anything. All right, I've had to run, I ran a lead out of here into that, so I'll be line, you know, line in, and I'm assuming I can use sub out of that Pioneer amp, which will send the sub signal and go up to there. Also got the wires here for the speakers, the switcher box. The problem is I'm going to have to balance the amp up here, wire this, run the front of power in, lift this and slide the amp underneath because I want this on top. So let's see what happens. That's got a, that's the input, that's the CD side of things. What are you, how do I not remember? Hang on. Oh, okay, that's from the computer. That's the CD player. And that would be, I'll figure it out. Alright then, surprisingly in the remote, it actually come with batteries. Surprisingly they left it. So, I guess if I go into radio, we'll see what happens and make sure the volume's right down. Alright, well, I can hear something. Definitely hear something. Okay, good. So that, shut up Google. So at least that means that I plugged the speakers in, right? I don't know about the sub yet, I guess we'll find out. I'll give you a bit of a zoom in on the what the display looks like. Well that's sort of what it looks like. A bit hard to tell because it is daylight out here, but it is bright enough out here you can dull it, but I'm not going to dull it of course. Alright, well so far I'm happy with the sound out of here. I mean they're not great big speakers or anything like that. But this certainly has a fair bit of balls in it. Better turn it down because you know YouTube's like they'll kill me. So I don't know if the sub will happen or whatever. I might need to readjust what I've done there. I guess we'll find out. No, we won't because I just heard it. Okay, it's not tuned in very well at all, but yeah, I'm going to have to adjust a couple things, but we'll come back with the next thing that needs to be added. My problem is where I want to put it. I don't think it's going to fit up here, so I don't know what I'm going to do. Hey guys, okay, before I continue, I just want to show you this. I don't know if you can see up here. We've got a lot of haze, which is actually a lot of smoke coming in. The other day, we were that thick with smoke. That tree you can see there, where I'm standing, I couldn't even see the tree. It was that thick of smoke with all the bushfires going on here in Australia. Tomorrow this is, it cleared up, but tomorrow is the beginning of it coming back, so we're going to be swamped with smoke and all sorts of crap tomorrow. But anyway, I'm going to continue on wiring this thing up. That other piece I was talking about was actually an equalizer I was going to get. Unfortunately it didn't happen. I didn't need one, but it looked cool, but it's not going to happen. Doesn't matter. So I need to figure out how to wire it up through that other amplifier for the sub. I did try it and I actually wasn't getting anything. So I've got to tinker and have a look and see how to get that sub going. Okay, maybe why I wasn't getting anything, it could be as stupid as a bit of a dodgy lead. I really don't want to be pulling this stuff out. Maybe I should move this a bit closer so I can balance it and then see if I can get anything happening with that friggin' sub speaker. Alright, let me just state this. When you're looking at the back of an amp, which is very difficult, when you got the pitch hanging on a friggin' angle, you're trying to look, plug the lead you want into the correct output. I don't know what the friggin' hell I had it plugged into. It certainly was not subwoofer out of this. It might have been sound channel, I don't know. But have a listen. Oh god, yeah. Radio sounds terrible. But she's going. That was so friggin' stupid of me. I looked at the bottom, I'm like, what does that say? And I'm like, looking at it like this, subwoofer. Dickhead. All right, I had to plug the rest of it. I had to pull it back out, plug the rest of these in, and straighten it up. So I'll kill that, kill that, kill that. You know how many times I've done this over the years where I've plugged something in wrong? Here's a note. When something's wrong, really check for the most basic thing that it could be, because 9 times out of 10 it's the most basic thing. Remember once as a DJ, I was in a major club and I actually had to put the decks together because they were pulled apart. I had to put them together, hook it into, we had like a massive array of amplifiers and stuff, so I had to plug it in. I was starting in half an hour, turned everything on, nothing at all. And when you go through a complete array of amplifiers, you check your decks, everything seems fine. There was also a screen that ran by a computer. There was a lot of computer related stuff as well. Well, you had a main preamp that ran everything. I'm not sure how it actually worked, but it was the smallest of buttons, very small. The bloody thing said mute. Now, I had worked at this club for months, and no one was ever there except me. Someone must have been there during the week and screwing around. I had half an hour to start. 5 minutes before things are supposed to get going. Hit the button, bang, the whole lot worked. So at that, I was stressed bad. I was running around like a friggin' chicken with its head cut off. I was really stressed. But most of the time, when something's wrong, like what I did here, I had it in the wrong output. It might have been an input, I don't bloody know. But it normally is the most basic of things that is wrong. And normally if it's not that, then it's something very, something very serious that's wrong. So it's either very, very basic, something very serious. In this case, it was very basic once again. As I said, it's happened to me many times over the years. All right, we're gonna get these leads in, get the CD player going, and make sure the computers are wired up and you're good, I hope.
Hey Google, stop. Stop.
All right guys, I plugged the lead in from out of the man cave, the computer out there, the CD player. Now if the CD player works, that lead will work as well. I'm gonna test it, but I'll put this out. Maybe there's a reason I couldn't see, you know, that where it said subwoofer out and all that. Hint, when you're playing with stuff like this, maybe don't touch this stuff, don't have a few of these because your vision starts becoming kind of blurry. But, oh well, it's friggin' hot. It was like 32 today. Ah, look at this, the speaker's coming down. Okay, I did put these up really, really well. But sometimes they can slip. I'll give you a look. That's one of the speakers that goes out to the backyard. Where are we? And it's kind of slipped out. I'll be able to fix that. Okay, it'd be real easy to fix. Oh, normally I'm on a ladder. There, done. All right then. Now I have no idea. All right. So we'll check this. Now I have no idea what input I use. I don't have a clue. Do not judge me on what music comes on. If you watch one of my other videos, the reason I have the CD player, it's full of really, really old country and western music. Do not judge me on what it plays. But I've got to find the right input. I can't remember what input I had.
You playing, you bitch? Play.
Okay, she's running. Shut up, Google. Well, it's in CD.
Duh.
Okay, I'll get the subamp on. It's really crazy, I couldn't work out why it wasn't working, because the way I ran this was exactly how I ran it in the main cave. Same way, so that's why I couldn't figure out what was wrong. Turned out it was just my vision. Okay. Okay, beautiful. All good. As I said, it's this is just loaded with like old country music and things like that, so it's what I like anyway. Alright guys, well that's it for this. And yeah, so I just got this, it's the Pioneer VSX D512. Yeah, right. And I got it at a swap. So let's see if I do end up getting that EQ, I'm gonna have to pull everything out again and rewire once again. It's full of lights and buttons and I like that sort of stuff, so. All right guys, well that's it for this. Catch you on the next video. Bye guys. Well, the T-Man, T-Man, revenue is too.